Trees and plants have very peculiar adaptations to survive in nitrogen deficient soils, especially the poor soils besides rivers and streams. So in today's tree talk, I will focus on actinorhizal plants, actinorhizal trees, the trees which are not in the family Leguminosae or pea family. In pea family, there is nitrogen fixing by another different kind of bacteria. But I am focusing on those plants which are outside the Leguminosae family or the pea family, Fabaceae, and they have the association with another kind of bacterium which is filamentous and is actinomycetous in nature. So such trees and plants which have the association with actinorhizal bacterium, actinomycete kind of bacterium called Frankia. And with the help of Frankia, they get nitrogen in such deficient soils, and in return, in for the service provided by the Frankia bacterium, these trees or plants, they offer sugars, carbohydrates to the bacterium. So that is the called symbiotic relationship in the world of plants. One of the tree which we usually see in mountains is called elder. Commonly we call it as Alnus nitida. Locally, charm or prag. This belongs to the birch family, but it can be distinguished with the unique presence of female buddi cones, the cones as we find in conifers. So, for the release of the seeds, these cones open up. So, they distinguish, but these are nitrogen fixing elders, Alnus nitida, and they usually act as pioneer species beside the newly formed soils, beside rivers where it is usually sandy and nitrogen deficient soil, where they are able to survive and make a firm foothold, conserving the soil, conserving the location, even helping in reclaiming the landslips areas. Apart from this tree, we have other nitrogen fixing plants or shrubs. One of the commonest and very famous shrubs seen in Ladakh cold desert, not only in Ladakh cold desert but also in Gurez part of Kashmir and also in ancient Avanti part of Kishtwar district. This Hippophis ramonoides, or even other species Hippophis salicifolia, or other species Hippophis turkestanica, that is a Hippophis ramonoides variety turkestanica, they all have the association with the Frankia bacterium in the roots, and they are also usually restricted to such habitats. Beside the rivers and streams, we find the sea buckthorn, as it is popularly known as Sarvang in Ladakh area. Lay berry, very useful, rich source of vitamin C, flavonoids, antioxidants. Its fruits are used in more than 300 products in China. This is anti-aging. Even the herbal tea stands innovated by the DRDO field research laboratory stationed at Leh. Apart from Hippophis sea buckthorn, we have another shrub which is very common in Jammu Shivaliks, especially Rajouri, Udhampur, Bilawar, Ramnagar. We call it as Ban Kanak. It is basically a kind of tree having the wheat grain like fruits, and they have the silvery scales, silvery white undersurfaces of the leaves. So it is popularly called as silverberry, In local, we call it as banakanak or kankoli. In English, oleaster. So this tree or shrub, Alagnus umbellata, here in Jammu Shivalik, Alagnus angustifolia Ladakh, again they are nitrogen fixing actinorhizal plants, having the association with the bacterium Frankia. Fruits are useful, medicinal, edible, eaten by the natives. There is another shrub which is seen in Shivaliks, in Bhadrawa, Bani Basoli area, in Kashmir Jabarman Hill Range, in Udi, even in Rajouri, we see Riyasi, Bani Basoli area. This particular plant has given the name to the hill station in Uttarakhand. Hill station we know as the queen of the hills, Masuri. The word Masuri, it is presumed, has come to become popular after the name of a local plant which was growing in abundance in those limestone soil rich formations. So plant is Coriaria nepalensis, because this is very near to Nepal, and in Nepal also it is found, and this particular plant is found in western Himalayas, again nitrogen fixing plant in the family Coriaraceae. And why it has been named Coriaria? Because corium word is a Latin word which means leather. As the plant has the rich tannins in its roots, bark and leaves, it was used for the tanning of the leather. Especially the species which we see in Europe, Mediterranean region, Iran, Iraq, Levant, called as Coriaria meritifolia. Leaves look like Myrtus communis. In New Zealand, we have another species which is called as Coriaria arborea, locally called as tutu. But all these Coriaria species, the seeds are poisonous. And in New Zealand, there have been cases of cattle and horse poisoning by consumption of Coriaria arborea fruits, leaves. But in the villages of Jammu hills, usually local people eat those berries. But if eaten in excess, it can lead to nausea, vomiting and upset stomach. So it is not advisable to eat the akins. Fruitlets are very tiny and they have one seed. Typical fruit called akin. So whatever is edible portion, that is derived out of the petals. So petals become fleshy and that turns into sweet or sour taste. And they have been in use even in New Zealand. Even in all other species, we can consume the fleshy petals but not the inner akin seed. This is also a nitrogen fixing plant. Leaves are opposite. They are many nerved, 3 nerved or 5 nerved. In case of Coriaria nepalensis, we see the branches are squarish, and fruits when they ripe become purplish. In Dogri language, we call it as a rikni. The another plant which is unique and is found in Ramban area at Makarkot, even in Gurez, Kopawada, stands introduced in the Botanical Garden, University of Kashmir, is Datiska canamina. The species name canamina reflects that it has the leaves look like cannabis, Cannabis sativa, bhang. The plant having the bhang-like leaves, but this is from different family, and this is called Datesca cannabina, where male and female plants are separate, and leaves are divided. They are pinnate, not palmate. In case of Cannabis sativa, we find they are palmate, but in case of Datesca cannabina, they are pinnate, sharply serrated and greenish yellow flowers. And this plant is also very useful. The God has created these actinorhizal plants to take care of nitrogen deficient poor soils and ultimately improving the soil quality so that other plants can also come and establish in such habitats after these pioneer plants make the soils that of that quality. So that is the way we see these actinorhizal plants useful in landslide reclamation. So at Makarkot, we have planted these Datesca cannabina plants 25 years ago to arrest the flowing landslide. Apart from Datesca cannabina, Coriaria napalensis, Alnus nitida, Hippophyramnoides, Alagnus umbellata, we have another plant, actinorhizal plant tree introduced in the University of Jammu along the roadsides, and this is Casuarina equisetifolia. Name is very fascinating. From a distance it looks like as if it is a conifer because the leaves are needle-like. Some have likened the leaves look like the leaves of Equisetum, another horsetail pteridophyte seen in the desert sandy locations. So many species of Equisetum we find, but they are not nitrogen fixing. In this plant which I am referring is Casuarina equisetifolia. Leaves look like Equisetum, but this is angiosperm. It has red flowers, and its fruits, they also become cone-like. So the look is of conifer because of needles and because of cone-like fruits. Casuarina equisetifolia is another tree which is actinorhizal. This is also nitrogen fixing plant and useful in sand dune reclamation. So it is used in reforestation projects in the desert locations in Rajasthan, Jodhpur area, Jaisalmer, and even along the coastal belt, South India, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu. Actinorhizal plants are diverse and they are reported under 8 families. So another tree which is seen in Jammu Hills, especially Samnabanj, Ramnagar Forest Division, and Kardo Nala near Bani. So it is found in Bani forests also, and Chodmotu area towards the Ramkot, Bilawar. We see this tree, nitrogen fixing actinorhizal tree called Myrica esculenta. Myrica, why Myrica? Esculenta means it is edible, and Myrica word has come from waxy nature of its fruits. It is also called as the wax myrtle for the same reason. It has the waxy fruits, purplish pink, and they are mostly eaten. They are delicious, even sold in local markets in Nainital, Missouri. But in Jammu region, we find few locations where this tree is growing. This nitrogen fixing, Myrica esculenta, is seen growing in the Bani area, Samnabanj area, and Bilawar forests. Myrica, there is one myrtle warbler in North America. There is also this Myrica particular trees seen. And this particular warbler, which is named as the myrtle warbler, has the capacity to digest even this waxy coating of the fruits. Otherwise, usually birds avoid because of this waxy coating on the fruits. And there is a link between if that myrtle warbler gets its fruits, Myrica esculenta fruits, to eat, it is able to proceed beyond to the northern Chile areas in North America. So whereas other warblers cannot go to that frigid zone, that cold zone in the northern limits of North America, wax myrtle or Myrica esculenta eating this particular bird gets extra energy to tide over the chill. So that is the ecological link between this particular bird and the Myrica fruits. Myrica esculenta is also known as the bay myrtle. And this tree, being nitrogen fixing, and it is already seen in some locations in some forests of Jammu province, it needs to be taken up by the forest department for its multiplication in the forest nursaries, so that such actinorhizal plants, which are native to India, native to Himalayas, native to Shivaliks, and they are useful in reclaiming the nitrogen deficient poor soils, and not only that, they are familiar to local people, and even its fruits are eaten, or some kind of medicinal use is also there in the memories of village elders. Such plants, which are called as actinorhizal plants, actinorhizal trees having the unique association with the Frankia bacterium, they need to be shortlisted and grown or included in our reforestation programs.